complete as per the diplomatic talk between India and Nepal, it is to be done by the government. And I think and the other aspect of Malays, and it is also internal dilemmas and internal conflict that is going on. I think it should be also more central. But we are making a change. Like let's say we are making a change. We need this go on with the dialogues and all that. We are doing that, but for now, I think it's such a shame on us that the concrete thing is not yet known, like what should be done. Exactly.
Thank you. This is a very crucial theme, and we are approaching the end of our session soon. We have time for a couple of comments or questions still. But before the end, we want to give the stage back to the Dalit Network of Finland. So I'm sure there's a lot of things to talk about, and we are happy to continue further. But we had two quick questions or comments from the audience. You first, and then.
Yeah, I just wanted to try to relate my answer, my opinions to what Beoma just asked. Like, we have the situation now in Nepal. If we have to talk about the situation of my country, then we have been facing the situation like the government side, it says there is no problem, and the protester, they say there is a problem. And it's difficult to solve the problem when we fail to recognize the problem. This is the real scenario of our country these days, you know. And secondly, about the demands, the protesters, they have a huge demands that can't be solved or that can't be addressed right at the moment. And since the constitution is so progressive that we can amend it any time with two-third majority in future, then why we are not able to discuss about this problem, why we are not being capable to address the problem. This is the real scenario of our country, as I understood. That's all.
Thank you.
Yeah, finally, we have the constitution. So like you said, it's better to have the constitution. So finally, we have that. Now, the problem is there from the section of Janajati, from the section of Dalit, from the section of women. There is a big human cry that this has been discriminated, some poisons not there, but this is not the major question. So like he said, question is what kind of constitution we have built. Is it progressive, is it rigid, or is it flexible? Our constitution is so flexible, all the major political parties and their leaders are so open to being all kinds of amendment in the constitution. So why there is a so big and human cry? We believe in democracy. When there is a democracy, there is a majority, there is a minority. Majority obviously wins, minority doesn't want to lose. That's why there is a power struggle. Now in power struggle, what happens? Minority cannot make the majority captive. The major problem of Nepal, like you said, there is not a recognition of problem, because the problem is what minority wants to make the majority captive. That's obviously not possible in democracy. You believe in democracy, you support majority, or you trust in majority. And majority is not just 50%. It's more than 80% of people's representatives have promulgated the constitution. So how can you say that our voice is not there? Who are these 86% people there? Are they over? Obviously, they are people's representatives. So question is, you believe in democracy. So we have to abide by the majority. That's the decision. So you don't follow the majority, and minority wants to have everything in bulk. That's not possible. That's not possible. Majorities should have an open chest to include the agendas of minorities, and minorities should have this tactics how they can include their own agendas with the majorities. So that should be developed, that should be discussed.
Dear discussants,
that's not the definition of democracy.
I'm sorry, I want to be democratic now, and my only choice for democracy is that we'll at least stick with the time, because we'll have some other things still before we leave here. So I'm sorry, I wanted to, what you said about democracy, I think this was crucial. Still, however, we have a gentleman here who has been wanted to raise his voice. So unfortunately, this will be the last comment for the general discussion. And after that, we will have closing remarks
and after that, of course, you can finalize
the
session and then we
can. I have a question for Sebastian. Well, we cannot deny the fact that not only our leaders can finalize the problem or amend the constitution. We all are well known about the role of South Bloc, New Delhi, and the Kathmandu, and the European Union, and sometimes some United States of America too. So, I would like to ask Sebastian that what European Union has to say about this current situation.
Thank you. I'll be very brief. I printed the European Union statement and have it with me here. So, this is the statement asks all sides of the conflict to reach a quick solution, so it doesn't really take any stance as to where the conflict originated or not, but just hopes for a quick solution to the conflict. We can discuss more afterwards.
So the international community is doing something, but many questions if it's still good enough, and personally I'm also questioning that. I'm looking at the rights of the vulnerable people and wishing for something quick to happen. So we will all wish for that, for the good of the nation. At this moment, I want to thank all of our guests in the front. I think we will give them a big round of applause once more. Thank you so much. And for all of you being here, it has been very good to be with you. I would like to give the final word now to Mikko Malkavara again, if you can please, as the representative of the Dalit Solidarity Network, what did you hear? How did you feel about our event?
I'm quite happy, but I have heard so many kinds of worries, so I really don't know how satisfied we should be. One of you from the audience said that it's better to have a constitution to have not, but how fragile is it, and what kind of problems it might cause to minorities. We'll see, but of course this kind of situation that there are protesters on the streets and the government doesn't want to admit anything. This kind of situations always cause more problems, from our point of view, we cannot estimate, but we can of course try to understand and know and to show our solidarity. But I'm very happy that this kind of forum was possible, and we got all of you here to share your points and your views, and we got so many people from the Helsinki Nepal community here. So I don't know how often you meet each other, maybe very often, but because I noticed that most of you know each other quite well. Yes, that is also very natural. But I'm happy that the Dalit Solidarity Network was able to host you this evening and give this kind of possibility for this very good conversation, and so thank you very much.
So we have the leaflets here in Finnish if you're interested, and we'll
thank you, all of you, to have this live from here. It's a live video. Thank you all for your kind support. Thank you for seeing.
It was live.